The pride of Hollidaysburg, Pennsylvania, Charlie Brenneman will compete in his home state for the first time as a UFC fighter tonight. And that idea has propelled him to new heights in his training camp as he looks to improve on his octagon victories.
This happened because of setting goals and making plans of action to see those goals through. It happened because I surrounded myself with the right people. It happened because I had core values.
King Kong banging on your chest. You can beat the world. You can beat the war. You can talk to God, go banging on his door. You can throw your hands up. You can beat the clock. You can move a mountain. You can break rocks. You can be a master. Don't wait for luck. Dedicate yourself and you can find yourself.
Standing in the hall.
6 years old, and I'll tell the story. You know, I was running around my house pretending I was Rocky. And, you know, Rocky, for whatever reason, at 6 years old, ignited something in me to chase that dream, you know. 8 years old is when I got introduced to the sport of wrestling, which was huge to me and formed my life. I mean, everything I am is a result of my family and wrestling. Some other people that could serve those roles: an older sibling, an older sibling's friend, a teacher, a coach, someone in the community, a mentor. My first wrestling match, I got pinned in 19 seconds. That was the only wrestling match I wrestled my first year of Junior Olympics. That was it. My second year, I came back and I was 16-4, and then like 40-4. And I remember these records from 25, 30 years ago. When I realized I had the talent, that's an interesting concept because there's a difference between talent and skill. So I knew from a young age, I would hear people say, he's a natural. He's a natural wrestler. Well, natural talent will take you far, but it won't take you to exactly where you want to go. So you have to develop the skills.
Be teachers, be politicians, be preachers, yeah. Be believers, be leaders, be astronauts, be champions.
It's the little things you do day in and day out. And those decisions, they're as small as choosing to not go to a party where there might be drugs and alcohol, choosing to get up at 6 a.m. and get a workout in before a party, decisions to study when you could go out with your friends. It's those decisions that after 20 years of making those tiny, tiny decisions, you know, they compound and all of a sudden you have this big result. It's easy to say don't quit. It's easy to fabricate a reason. Well, this isn't going my way. I'm going this way. I don't want to do it anymore. The biggest message I have is, if you surround yourself with the best people possible, you identify your goals, you execute your plan of action, whether you win or whether you lose, ultimately truly doesn't matter. And I'm not saying that because I'm trying to make you young people feel good about themselves, but it's truly the journey that makes the person.
Playing the winner by unanimous decision, Charlie the Spaniard Brennaman!
I put it together, the best inside the octagon.